Here's a fun little thing that you can do with your Mac. Say you like your screensaver, but you would like to see more of it. You can make your screensaver your desktop background. Yes, even if it's an animated screensaver. So here's how to do that. First thing you want to do is go into System Preferences and check your screensaver settings. So go into Desktop and Screensaver, Screensaver, and choose one. So here I've got that flurry one. You can change to this one. Might be more appropriate for a desktop background. So let's leave it at that. Now you want to run Terminal. I'm going to hit Command Space and run Terminal. So I'm going to type this command. I'm actually going to paste it in. The only part of this that is actually a command is this, Screensaver Engine, which is actually going to initiate this app that's hidden in here at this path. And then you're going to do it with space dash background. And basically what that's going to do is it's going to initiate the screensaver in the background. I'm going to include this in the text for this post at macmost.com, so you can just copy and paste from there. So what happens when I hit return? Well, there we go. Now the screensaver, and you can see if I move these windows out of the way, screensaver is actually running as my desktop background. I can continue to work here. I can open up Finder windows, do apps, things like that. Of course, this is going to impact performance somewhat, but it can be fairly fun and sometimes useful depending upon like which screensaver that you're using. It could provide a kind of useful function. It's fun to do. Now, here's the thing. You've got to keep this terminal window open. You can see it's actually running the app. It actually didn't even go to the next line. It's kind of paused there. You can simply hide terminal and put it out of the way, and there it is in the dock, and bring it up. But if you were to quit this, and you could do that with Control C there in the terminal, or simply quit the terminal app, then you can see the background goes away, which is probably desirable because I don't know if you really want that as your default thing. Maybe just something you do from time to time. Now, if you don't like playing around with terminal or want to do this without having to remember the command or copy and paste it each time, you can run Automator and you can create a new, and let's do this as just a application. And if you search here for shell, you can see run shell script. Drag that over there and paste that command in here. And then I can save it, and let's just save it on the desktop. And there it is. I can quit Automator, and when I run this, it does the same thing. And you can see since I'm running an Automator app, I get this little spinning wheel here at the top right. I can click that and you can see it's 0% completed because it's kind of paused there. And I can quit it anytime. So it's a little handy thing. I can put that in my applications folder. I can even have this launch automatically in System Preferences under Users and Groups when I restart my Mac. So there are various ways to get this going, but it's really just kind of a fun thing to do. Maybe a little trick, maybe something that you might like to have, say if you're just listening to music and you want to have this running in the background, but you still want to be able to check your email every once in a while, that kind of thing.